MIT biological engineers have devised a way to record complex histories in the DNA of human cells, allowing them to retrieve memories of past events such as inflammation by sequencing the DNA. This analog memory storage system, the first that can record the duration and or intensity of events in human cells, could also help scientists study how cells differentiate into various tissues during embryonic development, how cells experience environmental conditions, and how they undergo genetic changes that lead to disease. Many scientists have devised ways to record digital information in living cells. Using enzymes called recombinases, they program cells to flip sections of their DNA when a particular event occurs, such as exposure to a particular chemical. However, that method reveals only whether the event occurred, not how much exposure there was and how long it lasted. The researchers have previously devised ways to record that kind of analog information in bacteria, but until now, no one has achieved it in human cells. The new MIT approach is based on genome editing system known as CRISPR, which consists of a DNA cutting enzyme called Cas9 and a short RNA strand that guides the enzyme to a specific area of the genome, directing Cas9 where to make it cut. CRISPR is widely used for gene editing, but the MIT team decided to adapt it for memory storage. In bacteria, where CRISPR originally evolved, the system records past viral infections so that cells can recognize and fight off invading viruses. When using CRISPR to edit genes, researchers create RNA guide strands that match a target sequence in the host organism's genome. To encode memories, the MIT team took a different approach. They designed guide strands that recognize the DNA that encodes the very same guide strand, creating what they call self-targeting guide RNA. The researchers also showed that they could engineer cells to detect and record more than one input by producing multiple self-targeting RNA guide strands in the same cell. Each RNA guide is linked to a specific input and is only produced when that input is present. In this study, the researchers showed that they could record the presence of both the antibiotic doxycycline and a molecule known as IPTG. Currently, this method is most likely to be used for studies of human cells, tissues, or engineered organs. By programming cells to record multiple events, scientists could use this system to monitor inflammation or infection or to monitor cancer progression. It could also be useful for tracing how cells specialized into different tissues during development of animals from embryos to adults.